Ladies and gentlemen, it is Friday, the 4th day of November 2016. We are just 3.5 days out from the most historic election in U.S. history. Nationalism versus globalism, the entire world watches. Podesta, the chairman of Hillary Clinton's campaign, the guy at the center of WikiLeaks, only one window into this crime network, and it's foreign governments buying Hillary off. It's incredible corruption. It's manipulating the media. It's talking about rigging the polls with oversampling. Every crime you can imagine, proving she lied, to Congress and the FBI. In the emails, they talk about covering up the very investigation. Red-handed, open and shut. And we've warned the globalists. I had one of our insiders on who has high-level contacts in the NYPD 2 days ago, Doug Hagman. We need him back on today, even if it's 10 minutes. And he said it's going to come out that there's pedophilia, the occult, you name it. That's the headline from the article we did and the interview 2 days ago. WikiLeaks today, the latest data dump. Paul Watson gets it out first. DrudgeReport.com has the massive headline. We'll put it on screen right now. Clinton campaign chairman practices Aleister Crowley black magic. Menstrual blood, semen, breast milk. Most bizarre WikiLeaks revelation yet, with a high priestess who world leaders visit and top rap and Hollywood stars visit, who carries out a form of ritualistic sex magic developed, really just taken from older rituals, by Aleister Crowley. Menstrual blood, semen, breast milk, most bizarre WikiLeaks revelation yet. And, ladies and gentlemen, I told you that the Secret Service and others told us that they're into the occult, but I don't need to believe my sources. I have Bill Clinton in his own book, My Life, The Early Years, where he talks about how he loved voodoo, how God is manifest in humans through spirits, good and evil, and how he believes in voodoo. Voodoo is a very ancient form of this, but you notice it's manifest in every culture, the same belief that something's entering into you, but you've got to do bad things to open it up. So it's a psychological technology if you don't believe in God. But they've so blinded atheists and people that they won't even look at this as anthropology. Like, look at Haiti and what came out of Western Africa or Eastern Africa. Think about this. So we've got Bill Clinton writing chapters about how much he loves Port-au-Prince, the Haitians, and voodoo, and how God is manifest through this and how he believes in it. I mean, go read it for yourself. His book. Not mine. His book. This is their operating system. And in the Podesta email, where he's being invited to say, of course, he's going, they're promising him all the deliciousness that will be there. Paul Watson gets into the fact that the FBI and others talk about this perhaps being, not perhaps, leaning strong evidence towards code words. Code words for children. But it gets worse. In the rituals that she's released, it shows the severed head of a child, their high priestess. Again, appears to be an effigy, but it's got neck tissue hanging out, pouring ground up blood and body parts mixed with mother's milk into desecrate anything pure and good, dumping it on into the bathtub, and then they basically have sex in the blood. And everyone smears blood all over themselves and just absolutely defile each other. And then Paul Watson gets into it later in the article, and I'm going to come back. We're going to cover all of this, get into the history of it, and a lot more. Spirit cooking developed by Aleister Crowley. Urine, sperm, you name it. The ritual is performed. And again, they always call it art. But then they admit that it is an intimate spiritual ceremony. And the embedded video depicts bizarre nature of the ceremony. They mix all this garbage together. Then they paint on the walls about how to cut yourself and how to spread more blood. It's meant to symbolize the union between, and then it goes man and all this other garbage and the divine, which is representation of one of the prime maxims. As above, so below. Yeah, right. And then This is just a gateway, by the way, ladies and gentlemen, to larger stuff. This is what she's publicly put out. Then she's got the party that's in the emails where she's telling him about the menu and all the deliciousnesses, like she's talking to a connoisseur. Like, oh, would you like a Pinot Noir about from the Russian River, or perhaps something from a little bit further north in Oregon that has a little bit sweeter taste? I mean, what's your palate? And they just go through all the different deliciousnesses. And-